Why can't you give a straight answer? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I've gotten from time to time. I've looked at your answers for problems that seem like they relate to mine, but everything seems to be, check this, or it might be that. Why can't you just give me the specific steps I need to solve my problem? Why can't I get a straight answer? You know, it's a fair question. I really wish I could. Honestly, I truly wish I could give everyone a simple step-by-step, here's how to fix your problem answer. When possible, I try. Unfortunately, it's rarely possible for me to be that specific. There's a reason that my most common answer is, it depends. I don't want to sound like I'm trying to shift the blame here, but the reality is I rarely get enough information to determine the exact cause of a specific problem. I'm often not told of the symptoms at all beyond the ever-popular, it doesn't work. Without detailed information about the problem, there's little hope of getting a detailed information about the answer. I get that it's not always possible to know what information to provide. That's why I wrote an article on the topic, What Information Should I Provide When Asking for Help? It's a great place to start. Step-by-step answers often require step-by-step instructions to reproduce whatever the problem is at hand. And while not all problems are of the step-by-step variety, I can say this for sure. It is better to provide too much information than too little. When you experience a computer problem, you see symptoms. A symptom might include an error message, unexpected behavior, or a lack of expected behavior. The symptoms are not the problem. The symptoms are clues to the problem. What does it mean if your leg hurts? Well, most commonly it's a simple muscle strain, but it might also be an insect bite, infection, blood clot, cancer, or a variety of other things that I can't begin to think of. We need more information. As the TV doctors might say, we need to run more tests. The same is true of computer problems. When you report symptoms, you're reporting the clues I use to try to diagnose the cause of the problem. Sometimes, the clues are enough. More often, though, they aren't. The same symptom might have hundreds, if not thousands, of different possible causes. Now, since I can't sit at your computer and diagnose your specific problem, I can't run more tests. Like a doctor, I need to ask you more questions about the symptoms that you're experiencing to clarify what's happening. I might also give you suggestions to further diagnose or repair the problem yourself. In other words, tests for you to run. Much like that leg pain, resolving your computer's problem involves understanding more about what was happening prior to the symptoms' onset. Many people experience similar symptoms, or there might be a situation that I've never encountered before. In understanding more about what's happening, I'll probably suggest some things to try or to look at. Computers, like people, are incredibly complex. No two are exactly alike, no matter how you configure them. Different hardware, operating systems, versions thereof, applications, customizations, ways of connecting to the internet, and the methods of using the computer make each computer as unique as the individual user. As a result, blanket solutions to specific problems are rare. Obviously, I try to find them when I can, but often what works for one machine will not for another, and certainly not for all. What to try and how to go about further diagnosing the problem yourself, however, does work, as evidenced by the many people who take that guidance and resolve their issues. Unfortunately, computers are not like toasters. They don't just work. That means that at some point, each of us will face the responsibility of some diagnostic detective work. Now, there are lots of folks like me available to help, but ultimately, it'll take someone at your keyboard to collect the information we need to perform that final diagnosis and repair. And that someone is you. So, when asking for help, do your best to provide enough information. Expect that you might be asked to provide more information. Expect that you might be asked to run an experiment or two or three or more. Be patient. Understand that complex devices and situations often require complex processes to come up with less complex solutions. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/42522. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.